Good morning. Welcome to St. Patrick's Parish. We have the following announcements. Thank you to all who have given to annual partners in charity. We are at 78% of our goal. If you have not yet given, please be as generous as you can so we can help support the many ministries of the diocese, including the training of future priests that otherwise are not funded. Join others at St. Patrick's by volunteering at the Community Harvest Project, which helps distribute fresh produce to local food pantries, including ours. We'll serve for the final time this summer from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. on Monday, August 19th. Sign up at the doors of the church or by emailing the office. Join us for the Feast of Assumption of Mary, a holy day of obligation. Masses will be on Thursday, August 15th at 8 a.m. and 7 p.m. in the church. Finally, please pray for the restroom renovation project, which will begin tomorrow. May our Lord reward your generosity of prayer. Let us begin our prayer by singing hymn number 601, We Are the Light of the World, number 601.
Blessed are they who are poor in spirit, theirs is the kingdom of God. Blessed the Lord, make us poor in spirit, bless us, O Lord our God. We are the light of the world, may our light shine before all, that they may see the good that we do and give glory.
Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. My brothers and sisters, as we gather together this day, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are the giver of all things. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the living bread. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Alpha and the Omega. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth
we give you
us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that, with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the second book of Kings. A man came from Baal Shalisha, bringing to Elisha, the man of God, 20 barley loaves made from the first fruits, and fresh grain in the ear. Elisha said, "Give it to the people to eat." But his servant objected, "How can I set this before 100 people?" Elisha insisted, "Give it to the people to eat, for thus says the Lord, they shall eat, and there shall be some left over." And when they had eaten, there was some left over, as the Lord had said. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace, one body and one Spirit, as you were also called to the one hope of your call. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus went across the Sea of Galilee. A large crowd followed him because they saw the signs he was performing on the sick. Jesus went up on the mountain, and there he sat down with his disciples. The Jewish feast of Passover was near. When Jesus raised his eyes, he saw that a large crowd was coming to him. He said to Philip, "Where can we buy enough food to feed them?" He said this to test him, because he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 200 days' wages worth of food would not be enough for each of them to have a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish, but what good are these for so many?" Jesus said, "Have the people recline." Now there was a great deal of grass in that place, so the men reclined, about 5,000 in number. Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks, and distributed them to those who were reclining, and also as much of the fish as they wanted. When they had had their fill, he said to his disciples, "Gather the fragments left over, so that nothing will be wasted." So they collected them and filled 12 wicker baskets with fragments from the 5 barley loaves that had been more than they could eat. When the people saw the sign he had done, they said, "This is truly a prophet, the one who has come into the world." Since Jesus knew that they were going to come and carry him off to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain alone. The Gospel of the Lord. Our readings this weekend invite us to reflect on the mysterious and great power of God that meets the basic need of people, which is survival. This gift is not only for us as individuals, but also for the community as a whole. Both the first reading and the gospel remind us that though we do have a responsibility to care for ourselves and for each other, it's really God who provides for us. We live in a world that feeds us and shelters us and supplies us with everything we need to grow and to thrive. And all of this comes from the hand of God. Sometimes when we find ourselves in a desperate situation, we become painfully conscious of our dependence on God. But that dependence is there all the time. God doesn't merely intervene when we're helpless. God's providence is operating in our lives at all times. Besides being constant, it's extravagant. God gives us more than we need. The earth is prodigal in generosity. It yields food in abundance, food for our bodies, but also food for our spirits. God gives us everything we need to survive. He gives us food in due season, and satisfies the desires of every living thing. Living in a society that cherishes the individual and sometimes even promotes individualism, we can't undervalue the communal dimension of life. God certainly cares passionately for each one of us, but he's also concerned for the whole of people. In both readings, the bread was distributed to the entire crowd. As unique as we may be, we are a unique expression of a communal reality. God created a race. He formed a people. By his grace, we belong to the community. And yet, it's not enough that we belong. It's not enough that our needs are satisfied. As members of the people of God, we are called to a manner of living that is noble, not selfish. St. Paul also urges us to live our lives in a manner worthy of the call that we have received. If we look at our parish and the surrounding communities that we support, we are truly blessed and very fortunate. For example, we have a CCD program with enough staff and aides, with the help of our parishioners, to foster religious education for more than 300 of our youth. We have various ministries that not only help within the church, but also support the needs of those outside the church. We have a working food pantry, which amazingly never runs out of food, probably due to the constant support that it gets from our parishioners. We also have a council of knights who have supported the needs of this parish both physically and financially on numerous occasions, just to name a few. As servants and disciples, God owns us, not only by supplying our wants and needs, but by giving us the power to work with Him to sustain and help others. Even those who have little to offer, God can still perform great things. We are one with each other, not merely because we belong to the same species, but because we have been born to a new life in baptism. We all live by the same Spirit of Jesus, and we are all invited through the bond of God's love. The bread we receive from the hand of God is more than mere barley loaves. It is the bread of full life, life in all its dimensions. And as we work together, it's a life in and through and with Christ.
Let us stand now and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in our Lord and Savior, let us lift all of our prayers before him this day.
For all who teach the gospel message, especially all who joyously teach our children, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all on summer vacation enjoy their time with safety, never forgetting to be thankful for recreation and refreshment, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick or near death, and those who care for them, know the reality of God's love through the community's support, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those friends and loved ones who have gone on before us, for Father Dunphy, who passed this week, and for Albert Murphy, whom we will remember in this liturgy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the intentions of our parish prayer chain, along with those prayers that we hold in the corners of our hearts that are known to God alone, We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, strengthen us with every gift and grace and heavenly blessing, that we may follow and serve you as you desire, to enter into your heavenly kingdom, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
As our gifts are brought to the altar, let us join together in singing hymn number 432, How Great Thou Art, number 432.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all of his holy name.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty, rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God. With blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Patrick, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, and Robert our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children, scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Oh, God, you take away the sin.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We now pray the prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there. Unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
There is still a light that shines on me.
have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Our celebration is ended. Go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Have a great week, everyone.
As we go forth together, let us sing hymn number 342, I Am the Bread of Life, number 342.
I will.